I wanted to try something really quickly on the Apple Watch. There is a myChevy app. Let me scroll to it. Sorry, guys. And you can lock, unlock, precondition, and set your alarm. So I wanted to see how long it takes to go from my watch to my car to precondition it. So we'll tap that button. It's going to ask me if it's safe and legal. I'm sorry, I keep going back and forth. I wish there was an easier way to do this. Okay. It's loading. It was that quick. I actually cannot believe how quick that had just happened. Pretty impressive, Chevy. So, just wanted to record really quickly since I do not drive and record yet until I have a better setup. But I'm starting off today with the heat on with an estimated range of about 196 miles, which is, I think, is pretty good. It has a 100% full battery pack. One thing I wanted to do, I wanted to see what we'd be at without the heat on. Okay. That's pretty impressive. 223 miles without the heat on. Now, the car has been sitting in a garage that is not heated, but it is attached overnight. Like I said, 100% full battery. It is 39 degrees, and I will see where I'm at once I get to work with the heat being turned off and on. So, it's winter time. So I've officially made it to work, and it took me about 45 to 50 minutes, which is pretty typical. The car did really well. The tires did really well. They are still the all-season energy efficient ones. We're getting winter tires put on this upcoming Friday. But the car, I think, handled pretty well on its own. There was one time that I slipped, and that's because I had the car in low gear and I had heavy regen on, and I wanted to see what it would be like if I hit the regen pedal and I fishtailed. Luckily, everything turned out okay, but yeah, I'm safe. So, however, I had the heat on the entire way, so let's see what it was like with that. So right now I drove about 20 miles, and at the beginning of this video we had about 195-ish miles on the gasometer. Right now we're at about 162. You could see that it used some electricity getting here, but it's 28 degrees now, so I really wanted to be warm. I have my heated steering wheel on, but let's see what it's like when I turn off the heat. So it's going to jump up to about 180 miles. Without the heat when we first started was about 225. You can definitely see that running the heat is not very efficient for driving standards. And I drove about 20 miles on about 8 kilowatts, which is actually kind of a better record than prior. The one time I drove this distance on about 10 kilowatts. So I guess I'm starting to drive a little bit more efficiently, but you can see that the heat used literally about 40% of this drive, and about 60% was just literally meant for driving the powertrain. But it's starting to snow more. I'm at work, so I'm gonna get inside and get warm. But be safe out there, guys. This is gonna be part of another part two, probably part three of ownership of a Chevy Bolt. But the car did really well, and I'm impressed with it. But I can say that I'm very excited to get winter tires put on this car. One other thing that I wanted to mention, I forgot to mention at the beginning of this video, I do not have a level 2 charger installed yet. We are getting that installed on Friday at our house, so I could not precondition the battery using the electricity. The battery was preconditioned as I drove, so that used a lot of electricity. So, but I'm excited to get the charger put in so we can see what preconditioning does. So I'm at Twinsburg City Hall, where they just installed these two level 2 chargers. They're by Green Lot. They were installed about 3 weeks ago, I think I mentioned they were. And they are now finally working. I'm now charging my Bolt. Finally, if you guys are in Twinsburg, there's three locations, one by the city pool, the city hall, and then the city square or downtown. I'm gonna go check that out in a second. We'll see how this works. They're free for right now. So just a quick update. I've been sitting here for about 15 minutes now. You can see it is cold. It's about 27 degrees out. And we are pulling about it's been fluctuating between 5 to 6 kilowatts. This charger is rated at 7 kilowatts. I know with it being cold, sometimes it needs to warm up. So I guess we'll see if I actually do get 7. But I'm going to go sit and check out the city square and see how those chargers are working. It's a bit cold out here, but I am so excited. Like I said, I've been working, back in 2015, I presented data saying how Twinsburg needed EV chargers, what it would do for our community, how it would help EV drivers in the adopting the technology. And the fact that 4 years later, we now have 6 level 2 chargers in my hometown is just beyond exciting. I am so happy that we have these now. So definitely check them out if you're traveling through this area. So now I'm at the city square here in Twinsburg, charging my Bolt. Similar situation, level 2, with another charger on this end for 2 people to charge. So come check it out. It's beautiful here.